Hi friends, Mickey from Figma here, and today we're going to make a color wheel in Figma and talk about the hex values that make up the colors in that color wheel. So let's go. First, let's go down here and talk a little bit about the hex code and break it down exactly how those colors work. So when you think about that hex code, there's going to be 6 digits. The first 2 digits represent the red, the second 2 digits represent the green, the third 2 digits represent the blue. The way that they work is the amount of color in each paint bucket that essentially represents each pair of numbers. The way that they go is they go from 0 to FF. So if you think about those numbers as they're making their way up, they go 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. And as you think about that distribution, it equates to approximately 256 values between each paint bucket that we have there. So if you imagine making your way through even rounds, 0 would be 0, 32 would be approximately 20, 64 would be approximately 40. Halfway point, that halfway point between those colors is actually going to be represented by a number of 80, all the way to FF, which is a full representation of that color bucket. Now, the way that that equates with this color model, you can represent about 16.7 million colors. You've probably heard that before with other digital apps. So that's where that number comes from. You have each one of those paint buckets representing a number. When you put them all together, it approximates 16 values. Now, when we talk about mixing colors, on-screen colors are using an additive color model. And what that means is that when you add those colors together, so if I was to bring together the FF0000 with 0000FF in between that number there, which is the F's full on the red and the blue bucket, right? So there's no green here. It's going to be that magenta color. So when I add those two colors together, we get that magenta. When I add that green to that red in this additive color model, what we get is yellow. And yellow has full red, full green, no blue, and we can see that represented here. And then when I put together the blue and the green, we get this cyan color. And that cyan color, you'll see that when we add in the FF and the FF over here, so we add in that middle paint bucket and that last paint bucket, what we get is a cyan color. So you can see that sort of represented here. I'm using the lighten blend mode to represent these values, and you'll see in the cross section of all three, when you create all three and add those colors together, you're going to get a white in the middle, and that white is represented by FF FF FF. For those of y'all keeping count, that's 6 F's. All right, as we break down that color wheel, this is what we're ultimately working our way towards, right? We see the red here, we see the cyan here, those are sitting opposite each other, we see the purple here, right? Where are these colors coming from? What it is a distribution of those colors. So as we add into those paint buckets, how are we moving around? So when you have colors that are opposite each other, these are known as color opponents. And those color opponents, you'll see the way that they're represented. Once again, we're taking a look at this red. We're looking opposite of it. We're seeing that cyan color. So there we go. We have red and cyan. When you put them together, those opponents equate to white because those fills are filling up those empty paint buckets. Same thing with green and magenta. Same thing with yellow and blue. Now that we have this full understanding, we can go ahead and make ourselves a color wheel. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to press the O key and draw out a circle. Now on the right side of the circle, you'll see a little dot that says arc. We're going to open that up. We're going to click on this ratio dot from the sensor. We're going to expand that out, and then we're going to close the sweep. So we have this nice little donut that we're going to use to make our color wheel. I'm going to select that color, come over here to the design panel, choose the fill, and we are going to select a gradient. So we're going to make this a gradient. Now, to make this a color wheel gradient, we're going to choose an angular type gradient. Now that we have that set, I'm going to begin by selecting my first color. I'm going to have it from these colors here. I'm going to use the eyedropper and select that red. And that final color is also going to be the red. So we're going to go from red to red. Now here in the sensor, we're going to choose that cyan moving from the the counterclockwise direction. I'm going to pick that green as well as that yellow. And then going into the clockwise direction from that cyan, we're going to pick that blue. And then we're going to pick that magenta. So we picked the main colors here, and you can see that represented in the wheel. Now, if we want to evenly distribute it, if you blink, you're going to miss it. All I have to do is double click on those colors, and it'll give it a nice even distribution. So let's take a look at those colors and how they're mapping onto that wheel. We got ourselves a nice even distribution. So there you have it. We have our color wheel. Hopefully you found that helpful. And as always, happy designing.